What good is a mold design software if you can't work with standards? Here, we'll show you how easy it is to insert an angle pin. We'll select the angle pin function, the face we want to apply it to, and where we'd like to locate it on the slide. Next, we choose the insertion face on the back of our A plate. We choose our standard, and then specify which standard we'd like to insert. Click OK. TopSolid'Mold does the rest for you. Here you can see that the angle pin has been included. However, maybe we want to modify the angle pin. Maybe we want to modify the way it's trimmed at the end there. So we'll go find the type parameter, set it to 0, and there you'll see that it automatically trims itself to the back of that plate. Next, let's have a closer look at the slide carrier. Maybe what we'll do is make the slide carrier a little bit transparent so we can see inside, and that red dimension represents how that angle pin is controlling the overall stroke of that side action. Here we're going to add a clearance to the hole going through the side action, and you'll see that the driving point shifts dynamically. Next, we'll add another common feature. We'll go ahead and add fillets after the fact to that hole. And once more, once we compute them, you'll notice that that driving point changes again. So here, we're always trying to do our best to help you quickly design properly. Next, maybe what we'll do is add some screws. So let's turn everything off, maybe turn the core block on and the B plate on, why not? From here, we'll choose the screw function, and we'll choose to position it off the center of our mold base using standard ordinate dimensions. Choose the last component in the assembly we want to add a screw through. Find the standard we're looking for. TopSolid'Mold does the rest. It includes the standard at that position. And if we make a change to one of the dimensions, you'll see that it moves the component, but it's also going to move the drillings that are associated to it. But before we show you that, maybe let's go make a pattern of that screw. So here we'll choose a standard XZYZ mold base mirror. So we'll mirror about the center of the mold base. And like that, we have four screws. Maybe we'll turn off the one screw to show you that the counterboard hole and the tapped hole have been automatically added. And once more, we'll make a design change. And you'll see that everything updates automatically.